Today we're gonna test what happens if you put burning charcoal into a vacuum chamber. Are they gonna keep burning? Will they go out? Let's find out what changes. YouTuber Donta Sharp asked what would happen if we put hot coals in a vacuum chamber. Donta, we don't know, and so we are going to find out. We've got some hot coals, we've got a vacuum chamber. Let's see what they do. We got a camera and a light going inside. Let's see what happens when you turn on the vacuum. There's a tornado in there. We should film all sorts of things inside vacuum chambers. Oh, I see glowing. There's orange starting to show up on the edge of those coals. Oh yeah, that's picking up. They're starting to glow. Good airflow. There's charcoal in one type of vacuum chamber. Now, I'm sure what you meant was putting in a low pressure vacuum chamber, and of course we're gonna do that too. Let's talk about how. As a control, we are just gonna put some unlit charcoal into our chamber to see how that's different. My prediction is that we won't be able to see any change, nothing will move, we'll just have the charcoal sitting in there, and that's okay. The point of this isn't actually to see what happens in low pressure, it's to see what happens in low oxygen. And once those are burning, that should make a difference. Now to me, that didn't look like a whole lot changed, which as I said, is what we expected. Unburning charcoal doesn't do much in a vacuum. Now let's test burning, and like I said, we're gonna do this in a few different ways. We're gonna have burning charcoal down in our vacuum chamber, sitting on top of some KO wool so that the heat isn't directly transferred into the glass. We're gonna take another chamber, same size and shape, and we're gonna put some more charcoal in that. And that one, we're also going to add a bit of dry ice. Hopefully that will just flood the entire inside with carbon dioxide, and we can see the difference between a non-oxygen environment and a carbon dioxide environment. Then we'll have one final set of charcoal off the side, also not in a jar, it will be exposed to the air, but we're gonna use our shop vac to blow air onto it so it has sort of an extra oxygen-enriched environment. I figure that will give us a good spread from high oxygen down to no or opposing oxygen environments. We'll see which charcoals burn the fastest, and we've got a temperature gun to see what the difference is in heat. Here's the basic idea. We're gonna take some burning charcoal. We'll put it in a vacuum chamber, another chamber with carbon dioxide, a pile of charcoal just sitting in the air, and some more charcoal with added air being blown on it. One idea that we did have was actually to use pure oxygen to show what that did with the charcoal. There's a couple of reasons we're not gonna do that. One, this is not a very common situation. The air around us is actually not a pure oxygen environment. Most of it's nitrogen with some oxygen, carbon dioxide, and other elements floating around in it. The other reason is that these tanks aren't free and we actually go through them really quickly while trying this experiment out. We are hoping to let things run a little bit longer than that. But we did want to show you what happens when we put a pure oxygen stream onto one of these burning pieces of charcoal. It's pretty neat. You can already see how much it heats the coal up and gets it burning better. But watch what happens as I get the oxygen even closer, making it more intense. This wasn't a brand new canister, but it is now empty. Like I said, it goes through it really quickly. Look at that, where I was blowing the oxygen right in, it burned so well and intensely that it just tunneled right down through. It also threw sparks a lot. I think it burned me through my glove a little bit. Okay, now we're gonna fill this chamber with carbon dioxide by using the dry ice. So we're just gonna let this overflow down into that chamber a little bit. Of course, now the GoPro can't see anything, but it'll clear out mostly. Okay. A lot of vapor in there. Piece of dry ice down in there as well. At that point, there should be almost exclusively carbon dioxide in that chamber without really any oxygen or nitrogen or any of those other things. Our thermometer is currently showing our outside charcoal at 850 degrees, approximately. That's in Fahrenheit.
That's warm.
Okay, this puts out a lot of air. We're gonna be blowing that on the charcoal, and it's gonna start glowing orange like immediately. All right, quick update. If you remember, we are getting about 880 degrees Fahrenheit with the charcoal just sitting there. Let's look at what it is with the charcoal we've been hitting with the air. 1300 degrees Fahrenheit. We were, for a second it was at 1300. It's already dropping, but that was 500 degrees Fahrenheit hotter just from the vacuum. That's a lot. It's been 10, maybe 12 minutes that we've been letting all four of these types run, and we want to do a temperature update. Sorry about the noise, the vacuum is running, and we do want to let it keep going, but we're going to do a check. Oh no, we lost them. Well, let's do a check of this one. All right, at the moment, this tiny one is only registering 1200 per second. Before, when all three were stacked, this registered at over 1500 degrees Fahrenheit. So we're going to put that at 1500 because those just barely got blown over. Let's check the ones that's just sitting out. All right, between 790 and 850 is kind of what we're getting here. Our carbon dioxide, 287. Wow, that is 220 down there. That's like barely hot enough to boil water. This has gone way down. So under 300, definitely. All right, we are gonna let air back into this one. I'm gonna try and do it slowly so it doesn't fan the charcoal too much. 255, so like the carbon dioxide environment, this is really suffering on heat. We've let some hot coals sit out in the open air for a while, and they've gotten to the point where they're really falling apart. They're mostly made of ash, so I figure that's a good time to compare how they are to the ones in our carbon dioxide chamber and our vacuum chamber. Let's take a look. Most of our mass is gone from those. They've burned down mostly to ash. So let's do a comparison. We already looked at the ones that we were blowing with a vacuum, and those just, it took 10 minutes maybe, and they were just down to this size, or maybe even smaller. Gotta say, preliminarily, our charcoal in here doesn't look like it's been burning very much compared to this. It's about the size that they went in. So we've got 1,000 degrees surface temperature on these ones, 80 degrees surface temperature in these ones. All right, I'm gonna risk this and just grab it with my fingers. That's just out. There is no burning left to this. The carbon dioxide put that charcoal out completely. It's not on fire. I wouldn't call that a hot coal anymore. That's just leftover charcoal, no longer burning. All right, let's check our vacuum chamber. Also 92. Man, that is really similar to the carbon dioxide one. Okay, I'm gonna risk it again. Pull that out. This one feels a tiny bit warmer, just like a couple of degrees. Like, it does feel slightly warm compared to the dry ice ones, which just didn't feel warm at all. They felt fairly cool. But again, no danger in me holding this. They're not hot. They are not gonna burn me. Nothing is glowing. There's no ember left. Those are out. Donta Sharp, thank you for your suggestion of putting hot coals in a vacuum chamber. I think we learned some interesting things. It was really cool to see what it did. Guys, you know that's not all. We've always got more for you to see. Check out that box up at the top. It's going to take you to our last video. You should go check that out. The other box is going to show you what YouTube thinks you should be watching now. And if you hit this bomb here in the middle, you'll be subscribed to the channel. That way you're not going to miss a cool video. Don't forget to ring that bell, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then.